and I play bass, mostly in pit orchestras for various musicals around community theaters and high schools in the area and whatnot. But I'll play for basically whatever gigs I can get my hands on. Most recently, I was hired to play for a high school production of SpongeBob the Musical. And that musical has an absolutely star-studded composer list. It's got people like David Bowie, it's got Aerosmith, it's got Plain White Tees, it's got Flaming Lips, it's got so many people, and the music reflects it. It's really fun to do. So sit back, relax, hopefully you enjoy the video. This is my first gig vlog, so if I enjoy making it, then I'll probably make more, so slap the like button and pop the subscribe button. But who knows? Maybe I don't like it, maybe I do. We'll find out. The biggest issue with it, this musical, is that the high school is 40 minutes away. 40 minutes. And that's a long drive, but it's a new high school for me, and it's nice to get my foot in the door. So I'm really excited to see how their layout is and what all's going on there. So, well, let's find out together. Throughout this musical, I found two songs to be especially challenging. The first one being Super Sea Star Savior, a tune about Patrick Star becoming a cult leader. And the second one is a transitional song about SpongeBob and Sandy climbing the mountain. As you can see, Super Sea Star Savior is difficult because of how quickly the notes come, which is a staple in the gospel genre. Yeah, that took a lot of woodshedding. And the second song is difficult because it's bowed arpeggios in the middle of the bass, which makes intonation very difficult. Two songs that I absolutely have to mention. The first one is a simple song. It's some underscore for some dialogue between Plankton and Karen, and it's just titled Big Guy. So, for all you Bane posters out there, if you know, you know.
You're a big guy.
For you.
The other song is one called Bikini Tevka, which is really out of pocket. It's a song that's played while everyone in Bikini Bottom is marching out of the town in a really slow fashion. They're recording a video to raise money because, you know, a volcano is going to destroy Bikini Bottom and they're trying to get out. So they're recording a video to raise money for an escape pod, and they film themselves just trudging along with all their belongings, and they're really downtrodden and stuff, and it plays a song called Bikini Tevka, which, just saying, that seems like a bit much for a SpongeBob musical. Here is all the gear that I was prepared to use for the musical, including my upright bass, my 5-string electric bass, and amps for both, because I didn't think I would have time to switch in the middle of songs. Apparently that's not going to be an issue, because after showing up to the first rehearsal, I was told that they only wanted me to use the electric.
Jump out of bed, mix up a breakfast for my favorite pet snail. Full steam ahead, the SS I am ready is about to set sail.
So, I just got out of one of the two rehearsals for SpongeBob the Musical, and it was a good time. The school's pretty small, so
it's got the elementary, middle school, and high school in the same building. And instead of an auditorium or something, we were playing in the lunchroom. So that was interesting. That's a new one. The kids did impressions of the characters pretty well, but only for a little bit, and then they kind of forgot. But it is what it is. It's high school theater. It's a fun show though. It's a fun show, which it should be based on all the big names that wrote the music and whatnot. So I'm looking forward to the actual thing. Tonight we didn't do it with costumes. Tomorrow night they are doing it with costumes. So it'll be a completely different show. So I'm looking forward to it. We've got tomorrow night as the last rehearsal, and then we got a Friday performance and a Saturday performance, and then voila, it's over. So, yep, that'll be a good time. If you wanna rock, you feel it all right. Bikini bottom boogie all night. Getting 16, sweet red, gnarly and tight. Bikini bottom boogie all night. Toes out, heels out, head away. Finally, it was time for the first performance. So, I threw on my concert blacks, complete with my jazz socks, and hit the road. All right, time for the first show. Let's go. Years back, me and my younger brother started a tradition of listening to One Week by the Bare Naked Ladies on the way to opening night of a show, whether it's a jazz show or a musical. So I tend to stick to that. So you know what I'm gonna be jamming out to. It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Cock your head to the side till I'm angry. 5 days since you laughed at me, saying, get that together, come back and see me. 3 days in the living room. I realize it's all my fault, but couldn't tell you. Yesterday, you've forgiven me, but it'll still be 2 days till I say I'm sorry.
You get nervous before shows like this and stuff?
Yeah, but it's not like a, oh my god, drama. Oh my god. It's more of a, like, just don't.
As long as you don't mess them up.
Right. It's a bell curve for me. If there's nobody there to see me, then I'm just going. There's a few people there to see me, that's when I get really nervous.
Yeah.
And then if everybody's there to see me, I'm not nervous because everyone's there to see me.
Okay. Because, like, if there's 7 to 10 people, then, like, you can make out each individual person. But, like, this many people is just a crowd.
A little late tonight.
Who are you? Who said that?
Who are you people?
Show is about to start.
I know, and I couldn't be more excited. I'm SpongeBob's number one fan, Patchy the Pirate.
All right, I got this, you boy. Go away, you're sick of the orchestra or something. Now, where was I?
Thank you.
comes. The dark side volcano.
This makes my third musical in which a white person raps, one of whom was playing a grandma at the time. One of my all-time favorite parts about playing in a musical is the diversity of music that can be in it. For instance, we got the big composer list with John Legend, Cyndi Lauper, Aerosmith, David Bowie, and whatnot, and you can tell that those are their songs. So we'll go from, like, a big pop ballad to a country twang song to a big Broadway musical production number to klezmer music or something to a white girl rapping. It's just a bit of a fever dream, and you get whiplash from going from one genre to the next.
Thank you.
On the way home, disaster almost struck because I was almost out of gas and my phone was almost out of battery. Fortunately, I had $20 in the car because I also forgot money. So we made it out good. It's fine. All right, folks, that's it for this one. I appreciate everyone who watched it, and if you enjoyed it, like and subscribe to see if I ever do this again. It was a trial one, so if things seemed a bit wonky, then that might be why. I wish that I could show more of the musical or more of the music from the musical, but, you know, copyright and whatnot. But I appreciate anyone who watched anyway. And I'll see you with the next one. Bass Boy Isaac, signing off.